President Roosevelt issued Executive Order 8802, establishing the Fair Employment by the Armed Forces. From 1942 to 1949, a few brave African-American men changed the face of the United States Marine Corps forever. Faced with many challenges, they set out to make a difference and ended up making history.
The reason I chosen the Marine Corps, I had a brother in the Army. To keep from serving with him, I ran away and joined the Marine Corps. I joined another depot company and was with the 6th Marine Regiment when they invaded Okinawa. The only thing I did at Okinawa, I was armed with a carbine, which was a lesser weapon than the M1 rifle. And I carried ammo to the white boys or the white troops. And I brought the wounded back. And Harry Truman, which was president at that time, signed an executive order integrating the Marine Corps. And this is the only great experience I had. I had a detail, I think then I was a staff sergeant of 15 people. I was the 15th person to integrate to Marine Barracks, Pearl Harbor. When we got through Pearl Harbor that morning, it was about 11:15, the troops was in line for chow. And one of the troops asked, "What you got for chow today?" Someone said, "Nigger steak." And the fight was on. So about 2 o'clock that afternoon, the commanding officer had me and all of the troops present. And I didn't have any trouble after that. I think I served my remaining time at Marine Barracks, which was about 6 months. My 6 months duty at that time was just going through the command to see how the troops was being accepted.